floating camera was a quite famous design during 1920s to 1950s. A lot of models were made during those years, but only a few of them could be called legendary. This one in my hand is definitely one of those. This camera was made by the British manufacturer Ensign back in 1950s. It's called AutoRange 820. This camera could be one of the most advanced and high-end floating camera back then. And it is also the last flagship camera that Ensign ever produced. Any bright and warm winter day in Beijing could be one of the most beautiful day and the best time to visit any temple or palace. See this? This was made in England. This is Ensign AutoRange 820. This camera was made after World War II. Actually, there were not that much floating camera made after World War II because floating this kind of design is quite outdated. But otherwise, that could be mean those mods were made after World War II are all quite good. So this comes the question, why this camera? Called legendary. I think the answer could be quite easy. The design of the body and the image quality of the lines. So now let's talk about the design of this body. This camera was made in the 1950s, so let's say it's not a complicated camera, but simple doesn't mean easy. This camera have a very good and original design. So let's talk them one by one. First thing is the viewfinder. Of course, this is an high-end floating camera. It has coupled range finder. But check out this viewfinder, it's so huge. It could easily be one of the most big and bright viewfinder at those 1950 area. And for sure, it is the biggest and brightest viewfinder of any floating camera. Yeah. So this viewfinder means a lot. Everybody wants a bigger and brighter viewfinder. And secondly, is how this camera focus and how you manage that. See, there is a big dial cut through the whole body. See that? So you could easily turn this dial to focus this camera. Trust me, this is so advanced at 1950s because other floating cameras, they just tend to have weird way to focus the camera. And secondly, is how this camera focus. I wish I used the right way to say that. You see, the whole floating part moves as a whole unit. this kind of design solved a lot of problems. You know, like Zeiss, they just move the front element of their lines to focus. So you sacrifice a little bit of your image quality. Let's say a little bit, but actually it's quite a lot. Or like some other manufacturers, they come up with some very complicated design. It's not that much reliable, and you couldn't close your camera when your camera are not at infinity. But this camera, you could use it, you could open it, you could close it at any point. You see this? It doesn't matter. You won't damage your camera. And when you close your camera, you could focus. You could just do this on the street. And you focus well, you just open the camera and boom, take the shot. Other camera, you can't do this. So, in my opinion, this is the best body design of a 6x9 floating camera. Maybe the best design of any, maybe, but for sure of 6x9. The winter of Beijing is really beautiful. See that light. And now we're going to talk about another cool feature of this camera, is how you load film in it. Most 120 camera have two little knobs under the camera, and you pull those knobs out and pull the roll in, and that's how you load film in it. That works kind of okay, and most camera use that kind of system. But it's not the most efficient and elegant way, because especially when you wear gloves, you could hardly manage those little knobs. But this camera, you just roll this little magazine out of the camera and pull the roll in and roll this little part back in the camera. Done. Everything just works perfectly. And efficient and elegant. That's how you make a camera. That's how you make a legendary camera. You know, just you have to work with those little things. Another cool feature of this camera is this camera has dual format system. It can take 6x9 and 6x6. Most of those 6x9 floating camera has dual format system as well, but the other format is 6x4.5. I don't know how many people who hold a 6x9 camera in their hand will take 6x4.5 pictures. I will not. But 6x6, but 6x6 is a whole nother story. And this camera hold those little accessory in the camera, so you will never lose your frame accessory. But other cameras, you just tend to 9.5 out of 10, you lose it. You know, this camera just make you feel it's well thought. That's important.
When we are talking about this camera, we couldn't ignore another great one, which is the Voigtlander Beta 2 APO version. That camera has an 105mm APO lenser, and this inside has an 105mm color corrected rose lens. Both of them has the best design and the best lens at the time. They've shown us how great could be a floating camera be in the mid-50s.
开门，光圈，过片，
有点像战地摄影师的感觉。
And now let's check out the pictures. Check out the color, contrast, and the sharpness. This is really indeed a legendary piece. So, this is the story of Insign 820. As what I said before, this camera could be one of the two most collectible floating 6x9 camera on the planet. But you have to remember, the other one, the Voigtländer APO Bessa 2, is made by the most amazing and powerful brand on the entire photography history. But Insign is just a small company in British. And this mod could be the last major mod this brand made, because Insign just out of business in the mid-50s. But all of those problems didn't stop Insign to make the best of the best. They never lost their dignity. They never act like a loser. They will fight like a winner. Just like those British guys in World War II. So I think this camera could be called a true British camera, a true legendary.
Lancelot.